beat Fnatic. Steelback and Betsy still have shown some prowess.
I certainly agree. Let's see if they can do it against Giants today. Starting out, the Swain ban, something that we saw a little bit more commonly earlier on in the split against Rocket, followed by the Lucian. No surprises with the Nidalee taken away next.
And the thing is, Swain typically has fallen out of the meta in a lot of circumstances. Betsy, it's still one of his most played. We now see the priority on Malzahar coming out. Betsy played a lot of Ryze yesterday. Knight played a game of it as well. We may see the focus go over there. Vlad or Ryze will be available in this scenario. So will Rek'Sai, Elise. Two of the junglers here are going to be available depending on exactly what the last ban is. Likely to be Rocket going to ban out, I would imagine, the Ryze and give away the Vladimir. There are some better matchups into it that we have seen a few. Vlad obviously had a couple of nerfs.
This is true. They haven't hit the jungle at all, like you said. That last ban, as they tick the timer down, is actually going to be the Kog'Maw. Interesting.
Now, we saw that out of Giants yesterday in their loss up against Schalke, where Giants picked Ryze, they picked the Kog'Maw, tried to play for a later game setup. They had a Fiora for Smitty J, which is available in this game and may very well have high priority, but that isn't going to be the case for the first round of picks.
Yeah, the Gragas comes in. The Rek'Sai was also available for both the junglers, and also, crucially, like a Karma pick was up.
We've been talking a lot to Maxlaw yesterday, and he just feels like Gragas is so unbelievably strong. He was saying his ultimate has so much presence. The flash after the body slam, if that is available, is always a very dynamic tool. You can use it very effectively to gank in the early game as well. So Maxlaw was not too fazed by a lot of the other junglers right now. It feels like Rek'Sai doesn't quite have the same impact with the flash W.
I know, and Memento didn't even try to psych him out on Twitter, man. This is a stone-cold killer in the Giants jungle. We'll see how Rocket can handle him as the Trundle and the Karma are locked in.
And you mentioned Karma not being first pick. That is something that actually we saw a downfall of yesterday. A lot of Karma bans and only a handful of very high priority on Karma when it comes to the blue side. A lot of Trundle came out yesterday in the first pick. Three out of the five Trundles as we headed into the last series were actually first picked. Trundle right now, we're seeing a lot of flex once again. Have seen it a little bit in that support role, but obviously this is a dual flex. Rocket can leave whatever they want until their last pick. They'll likely go AD carry and jungle in their next rotation and then see where the chips fall for their solo lanes, what exactly they want from their setup.
Yeah, waiting to see what Giants decide to lock in next. 10 seconds on the clock for them. Still have their pick of the litter. With what was taken off the board in mid, there's still some very strong picks. The Vladimir may just be the case, and it's locked in with Sivir. That's a lot of mobility.
Yeah, and it's a lot of engage as well at this point. You've got the Gragas ultimate to start fights out for you after that Sivir ultimate gets popped. This is a pretty good team fighting setup for Giants, so I wonder whether they'll go 1-4 now, take the Fiora for Smitty J, and take the rest of the team here as that four-man stack. Looking forward to seeing what Rocket are going to give us in response to it. The Jhin is available if Steelback would want it, although doesn't always synergize particularly well. Of course, it's very long range, so should be able to avoid the fights for a lot of it, but doesn't exactly pair amazingly well with regards to some of the engage that Rocket wanted to set up.
Yeah, we've seen him hover the Caitlyn and the Jhin, both favorites of his, and it looks like he will fall back on the Caitlyn pick.
A little bit more towards that siege potential with that Caitlyn. I wonder what they're going to end up rounding things out with as we'll continue this one through. Giants, as you said, have that Fjord available, but into the Trundle. We've seen that go both ways. We may see the Gnar come out from Smitty J. Trundle, not exactly the best matchup for the Gnar, and Hustling again.
Again, he locks the turn. He does it so quickly, too. I mean, this guy knows what he wants. So they take that, and Smitty J trying to decide what he wants to take his last pick on. The Jax, he busted out a few weeks ago to great effect, but the Fiora has been creeping back up in priority. So what do they grab? It looks like it will be a carry. So which one?
Which one? I still expect some sense of, they could still swap up to Gnar for a decent matchup. May not give them quite as heavy, like not split pusher sense, but like duelist potential.
Mm-hmm. Up against the Trundle.
Okay. That Jax has been locked in.
It is the Jax and it is the Taric. That is a team that you don't want to tango with without being able to get out of harm's way.
And this is the thing, if this Trundle ends up in the top lane, Trundle into Jax, of course, Jax denies a lot of what Trundle wants to do, so you kind of time out a lot of Trundle's damage. with that Counter-Strike. We may very well see it stick, though, and just be a kind of a lane deterrent for a while. You inevitably give up that lane against the Jax. There's going to be a point where Trundle cannot afford to be in lane against him, so depending on exactly where this top lane matchup goes, we could still see the Karma go to the mid lane, Trundle go to support, and then if they pick the Shen or some of the others that they've hovered over, it may very well be the case.
Yes, indeed. So they're still trying to decide on if they want to swap that one around or give Betsy something else in the mid lane, except for besides the Karma. We saw him hover a couple of interesting picks, but as the timer ticks down, starting to trend towards that Shen.
It is the 1-4, though, for Giants, and with Shen locked in, Rocket are looking for something somewhat similar. They now have the Caitlyn for sieging. You've got yourself a Karma to keep everybody safe, and that Shen now over on the side lane. Again, Shen into Jax is another matchup that later on will go Jax's way. If this game goes late or Jax gets ahead, he will take over that lane and Shen will not be able to sit there in the side lane against him. However, for the early game, Shen has a lot of presence against the likes of a Jax because of the way Shen's denial of auto attacks works as well. So it is a bit of a skill matchup in the early game. Jungler presence is always one of those ones that can affect things fairly heavily. So both teams running potential 1-4s, there is always that Rek'Sai element to go 1-3-1 if they want to with Memento.
Yeah, there's a lot of global presence that Memento can bring with the Rek'Sai, but even in the early game, the ganks can still come pretty hot and heavy. We'll see if that's the case, if we have the standard lanes, or if something different happens as Grabs and Lotharq shake hands to walk off stage for this game number one. Interesting pick and ban selection indeed. A lot more to play for on the side of Giants, but Rocket, they still want to keep their skills sharp heading into promotion tournament, perhaps pull off the upset and upseat Origin. What do you guys think at home? If you want to tweet, at LOL Esports, of course, is the place, but you know, hashtag GIA win or hashtag Rocket win, ROC win, that is.
I was going to say, that might be a bit of a long hashtag.
I mean, you can use that if you want, but we won't be able to track it.
It won't get added into the numbers. However, one thing I am predicting, I'm going to make a prediction for you, Devin.
All right, let's hear it.
I feel like Giants very likely have to lane swap this. Caitlyn and Trundle into Sivir when you've got a melee support in a Taric is a very tough situation. Theoretically, stunning the Caitlyn is highly unlikely, and Sivir does badly in lane to both of those picks.
I've got a counterpoint to you.
Okay, what do you got?
Step on the traps with spell shield.
So
yeah,
everybody,
it's not as good as it used to be.
Everybody always says that, and then that's actually just a really bad idea as it is, because what happens from that is you spell shield the first trap, and then Trundle pillars you, Caitlyn puts down the second trap, and you don't have spell shield anymore. You can't spell shield the pillar as it is, but it's that trap that follows that makes it very, very difficult to follow up. So I see what you're saying, Devin.
So what you're saying is, it's a trap.
Yes.
Okay. Don't do it.
Call Admiral Akbar.
Just a little bit of advice for all of you budding LCS pros out there, don't step on the traps.
Yeah, don't just use the spell shield willy-nilly in that bottom.
No, you've kind of got to save it. So we are expecting that lane swap. We'll see if that's the case. And the game's all loaded. We're ready to rock and roll. And the crowd is certainly ready. Oh, this is going to be a good one. I can feel the energy already.
Yeah, I can feel the energy. Was that a Rocket versus Echo Fox banner?
That is not what I expected to see.
Well, we had that on this
one. We did have a bit of a debate.
I can't believe you and Trevor gave up on Rocket.
You know, we might have done it a bit prematurely. I agree.
You did.
I think Rocket have showed a lot of heart in the last couple
weeks. Do you not watch Echo Fox play? They literally just try and farm.
I'm not going to lie. I don't always.
Unfortunately, I had to watch a lot of Echo Fox recently.
I mean, I was just thinking about foxes and cats. I'm like, I think a fox would probably mess up a cat's day.
Depends how big the cat is, I guess.
True. But I was going with house cat.
What I feel like is I still trust in Steelback, to which I don't know whether that's a very valid piece of analysis there, but I feel like Steelback is still performing. Yesterday, we also saw the rest of Rocket perform against Fnatic, so I feel like they still have a little bit more bite to them.
Well, he's a guy that they can certainly rally behind. Steelback has been one of the more consistent players on Rocket throughout this split, and that's a really good sign for them heading forward, even into promo tournament, because they can kind of rely on that and that experience that he brings and that skill that he brings and rally behind him again. So we'll see how it shakes out in this game. They do start the swap up top, and we will in fact see Smitty J and Maxlor hanging out in the normal positions.
And I think this actually right now is Rocket trying to call the lane swap from Giants. They didn't have full vision on it, and now they will actually show. Although the fact that they're going into the Gromp potentially does signal that Bruckhead are now expecting the swap from this. They have even now seen Taric and Sivir on the bottom side. So Giants will find themselves in lane swaps. Mini J is going to try and interrupt here on Raze. Oh, sorry, Raze is going to try.
He interrupts the interrupt.
Smitty J, yeah, exactly.
Yeah. Oh, this is getting real bloody right now. Raze just keeps on going, clubbing down Smitty J. He's getting very low. The chomp, the ignite.
Oh, he's
Smitty!
Ooh.
He's going to get away with a sliver of health.
Just the potion. The potion was enough to keep him alive at that point. I thought Smitty J had fallen, but we saw something fairly similar the other day. Well, we see this fairly similar all the time. This is the importance of having that camp still alive when you interrupt. KiwiKid actually in North America went and did an interrupt when the camp was already dead and ended up dying for it. So Raze showing how you meant to do that a little bit better in that scenario. Used that ignite, got the flash from Smitty J, and now Smitty J has used his teleport to get down into the bottom lane. We're into the lane swap. And I think the pacing is ever so slightly in Giant's favor.
Oh, yes, indeed. Still, more even than we could have expected, maybe, with the swap. I think really want to keep an eye on this mid lane, though, because Knight will be a ticking time bomb for Betsy to deal with. Still, Karma does fairly well into the Vladimir, for the most part.
Yeah, fairly difficult to kill the Karma, fairly difficult to kill the Vladimir as well, without Knight making a
Giant
mistake.
Yeah, this is a death denial. In all honesty, like, watching a Vlad as a play-by-play is always really frustrating because, like, he's gonna... No, he's fine. He's Vlad. Again.
Again. And after six, he hits Hemo Plague on, like, four.
And then he just kills everyone.
Just kills everybody, yeah. Gets all of his health back. And suddenly, there's no threat against Knight. So there are the turrets starting to go down. Roughly even time. As we see, both top laners still only level one, forced out with both teleports to get there. So early start to this is very low econ for the top laners for now. Jungle presence hasn't really had too much of an impact either. Both Maxlor and Memento have kind of dodged around each other, but Memento has a heavy CS lead right now. Maxlor had to go and help out a little bit on the push, I believe.
Knight's been chunked a little bit low. Yeah, I was going to talk about CS, and it looked like Betsy was getting the better of it for a time being, but Knight just caught right back up to it. So Sonstar and Hustlin, they head topside, and Parang is going to have to back away now. The reverse push may take a little while to come into effect. You can see a lot of Rocket members moving down towards this bottom. Steal back and Raze forcing Smitty J out. So low econ is the name of the game if you're a top laner
now,
this game.
Normally Pyra, in this kind of situation, we'd be talking a little bit about promotion tournaments and, you know, how to challenge a team's lane swap. But the high likelihood is 6:15 will have become an impact on the meta before we actually get there. So for 6:15, with the adjustments to the lane swaps, the next patch where everything's a lot more about the 2v2, there's the tower first blood, I actually don't know whether Rocket will have an advantage in their macro game in the early game against a lot of the challenger teams. That's something we'll find out next week. We'll see if Rocket can get themselves off 10th spot today with a 2-0 over Giants. Could be quite tough, though.
Yeah, we'll have to see. I mean, this is, if anything, it's a training ground for them right now. And, you know, in splits past, we might have looked at this and said, hey, you know, these are two guys that were going to be vying for a spot in the promotion tournament. But Giants have just massively improved, and they've gone up and up and up. It's fallen off a little bit in recent weeks, but this is a really great performance from them overall on the split, and they've really come together as a team. It's not just the Holy Trinity that we always talk about, but even the bot lane has started to step it up pretty impressively.
Especially when you consider that, you know, there was very little expectation of this happening. We've kind of now obviously shifted our expectations on the split as this has gone through. Phase two of the lane swap is nearly complete. As you can see, Dragon is being taken down by Rocket.
Very good Dragon for them as well. The Ocean Drake early on helping out if they want to skirmish.
Yeah, also helps them out in sieging situations, of course, as well. There's not a whole lot of poke coming out from Giants, just the Sivir. So not a lot is going to affect them too much, should extend some of their sieging. Maxlor again going aggressive into the enemy jungle, is still behind on farm, but it's not all that much right now. We'll see if the experience is the big difference, because Memento actually has about 3/4 of a level over Maxlor when it comes to experience. So we'll see whether that first ultimate that comes out from the Rek'Sai has a big impact on the game before Maxlor can get his ult.
Yeah. Slight disadvantages, but Rocket do have that one dragon difference. There is another one coming up, will be Infernal in some time, but so far the vision game, you can see in the river, it's pretty much been all Giants since the swap really didn't allow Rocket to get involved in anything else like that. You take a look at the fan vote here, still people are believing in Giants, and, you know, Rocket are definitely the underdogs, but they've shown that they can at least take a game off some of the top teams here in Europe, and they've been playing with a whole lot of heart in recent weeks, despite the fact that they're really not playing for a whole lot, relatively speaking. Giants can't afford to really drop too much if they want to, you know, get a leg up on the competition. They can potentially lap Fnatic, and that's not something we thought we'd say at the beginning of the split either.
No, certainly not. We heard Max Law talking about, you know, we're trying to play to avoid G2. The funny thing, the way that the games have worked out today, Pyra, is that we actually go up in relative importance throughout the day because Giants don't know their fate yet. A win here is basically everything that they have to do because from there, they got to hope Splice win and that G2 end up... No, they in fact just want G2 to win if they win here.
Because when they bust out the brackets.
Fnatic can get switched around, that's when Giants can overtake.
Yeah. But that's so much complication to think about right now.
Yeah.
Giants, it's as simple as win at the moment, and then you can hope a little bit later. You've got the rest of the weeks to worry about playoffs. Knight a little bit low here as you see Steelback and Raze making their way towards mid, trying to make a power move here. As Smitty J is a little bit preoccupied with the farm up topside, Memento moves in. You see Hustlin and Sonstar coming for relief effort, but Memento is around the backside. We'll see if they make a move.
This is dangerous for Rocket. They know, obviously, Sonstar was there.
Oh, but Knight.
Knight.
He's going to have to pull away. Hustlin comes in. Dazzle. It goes back
go.
Around the side, forcing the flash out of Steelback. Knight is low, and that's a first blood. Inner Flame from Betsy secures the kill.
Knight just too low. Was trying to go forward to get any health back he could there. He didn't really need to be making that kind of presence felt in that scenario. Maybe looking for a Hemo Plague and then flashing out to try and get the heal and some of the damage down for the rest of the Giants team. But Knight, an uncharacteristic mistake, as we've come to know him, be fairly consistent just on this. Vlad gets hit, gets taken down, and suddenly Giants find themselves on the short end of first blood.
Yeah, not only that, Knight used his ghost. Rare mistake out of the Giants mid laner. And Rocket clear the way to start pushing forward. Betsy will be happy with that gold in his pocket. Let's take a look at it one more time.
So he ends up on the trap, doesn't get hit by the tether. And look, they want to go forward here. Knight, as he moves, what's he looking for? Tries to get the E, but it looks like it doesn't quite connect in the way that he wants it to. Couldn't transfuse, didn't get the Hemo Plague down as well. So just ends up dying.
Yeah, sometimes the low health, Vladimir, still a trap for yourself. Memento. Keeping on moving, tunneling through his own jungle. Consistently starts off the Rift Herald to give it to Razor. Accidentally. Interrupts in there as they get the ward clears off, trying to push deeper into Giant territory and look for Sonstar popping on the hunt. And they go in, bringing the Shen as they go, and Sonstar's popped.
Really nice punish from Rocket here because they look at the bottom side of the map. They see Smitty J down there. Yes, he has his teleport, but the key thing here is if Smitty J teleports up, he loses all this experience from the wave, and then it starts pushing away from him. Sonstar was too far pushed up. Giants can't bring the people up to the top side to actually cover for him. The Shen ultimate is used, but they remain with the teleport available for Parang as well. So Rocket managed to make a second kind of play on the map, this time getting a second kill.
Yeah, Hustlin, they might get a third here as Betsy lays down the tether, gets exhausted. In comes Knight. That will deter them for now. The Giants on the back foot and on the short end of two kills, as you mentioned.
Hustlin did just use his exhaust, though, so that could be impactful, although not a whole lot of people to exhaust right now in this scenario. I mean, Caitlyn's damage, of course, you can exhaust some of. Maybe Betsy if he starts coming into it, but honestly, neither of them are massive exhaust targets at this point in the game. But for Giants, with 1 minute and 10 until Infernal Drake, they'll likely be looking to even up the Dragon score for themselves. Of course, Ocean was taken down by Rocket earlier.
Yeah. Infernal is not going to be quite so good early, but it'll definitely pay out benefits the longer the game goes. Giants invest a lot into this bottom side of Rocket's jungle, securing a lot of vision, making sure that they will be spotted if they come in and try to force a fight for that dragon. So Giants clearly have their priorities there.
Yeah, they have a very clear setup on that. Already pink wards around the area. You can see Parang on the top side has the wave pulled in towards him a little bit here, so he's likely not going to shove that out too heavily. Although it is pushing away from him, so he will now kind of be at the mercy of how that wave moves. Smitty J hasn't moved up there yet himself because he doesn't want the same kind of thing to happen to him that just happened to Sunstar as well. However, with Caitlyn on the bottom side, it's highly unlikely. They've also just spotted Memento and they know he doesn't have his ultimate available.
Okay, I might have misspoken earlier when I said Karma does all right into Vlad. Apparently, it's really good. Betsy has been really giving Knight a hard time, and he is one of the stronger players that we've seen on Giants as Memento finds himself caught with Hustlin, tunnels away, and the pillar will cover his escape.
Karma into Vlad is decent when you look at the lane setup, and obviously, as I said, very difficult to kill the Vlad, but also, to kill the Karma, but it's also fairly difficult to just push the Vlad out as well. You can push him in, and that actually stops him from being able to do too much more on the map, but it's not like a dominating matchup you should be end up crushing in. It's just a fairly safe matchup where you can get a little bit of a lead. Mm. Of course, it helps that he killed Knight.
Yeah, I mean, Betsy's just been playing it incredibly well right now, and that's an encouraging sign as Rocket looked to start off Infernal Dragon, the Scuttler Vision, granting Giants a view of what's going on. They'll look to fight for it, but they've got to wade through the Caitlyn traps to make it happen. Meanwhile, Dragon's getting chunked down. No one wants to step on these, so they carefully watch themselves as the teleport comes in here for Smitty J. Memento going in with the Shen. The tunnel, Parang gets the taunt, and they turn for Memento, but Sunstar goes down.
In
comes Smitty, and around the backside, he's getting the Counter-Strike on, and Steelback going way too low. Raze gets taken out by Knight, drains the last of his blood, and Parang is one of the last men standing, having to flash away. Betsy untouched in that fight, but Rocket lose out big.
That's the kind of area where you do not want to fight the Giants. Knight comes in from the top side, four people stacked on Rocket that have already taken damage. This is a teleport coming in for Parang here.
I don't know about this one. Parang's coming, but it's already a little late. Parang goes in, but he's in down to three members, and Betsy's nowhere. That was not the most ninja move you could have made. And Maxlore, though, he might go down if they can get the equalizer. They do. Betsy secures the kill, but Memento will fall. Knight stays alive. Smitty's gonna back off from Betsy, but there's no more mana.
No more mana. Q cooldown is not quite available yet.
Oh,
there it is. Good
block by Sunstar. Man, he is real hungry for kills.
They still want to chase this. Betsy's coming all the way through the jungle.
Sunstar's low, but dazzled.
Got him. Sun's in his eye. So I guess Moon, Mount Targon, all like that.
Gemstones.
Gemstones.
I don't
yeah,
care about the rework. It's still gemstones.
Yeah.
At least on that skin.
No, exactly. It's not quite pool party time. That would be Suns in the Eyes, I guess. But there was certainly some obstruction of vision in this point. Here comes the TP earlier in from Smitty J. Knight initially gets zoned away and locked down, but look how this fight progresses here. Four people all boxed in for the Hemoplague. Actually only hits three, but it's still great from Knight. Manages to follow up the rest of his damage. Hustlin couldn't quite stay alive, but that doesn't matter, as Maxlore managed to get himself away from the dragon as well and just force it to reset before they manage to take it down. In the bottom left of your picture, you can see the Giants are on the Rift Herald right now. This was the teleport in that followed. Sunstar, there's the trap block with the spell shield. That actually allows his team to kite back down and effectively. If Sunstar hadn't have done that, this escape would have been so difficult for the Giants because somebody would have had to have stepped on that trap and would have ended up dying. And this is a very extended fight as we managed to continue through. Nobody died after that. They managed to get themselves
except the Rift Herald.
They accept the Rift Herald.
Yeah. So Smitty J grabs his buff. He's going to be a bit of a split pushing menace, I would say, for the next 20 minutes, but he's jacked, so pretty much all game. Although, they've really been finding ways to fight it out. I mean, Giants did a great job of, you know, clearing through the traps, making sure they could force Rocket out. And Rocket just took a unexpected fight, in all honesty. Knight forcing Betsy away as they continue to clear some vision around that river. 15 minutes into this game, it has definitely been quite bloody, but Giants in the lead, or not in the lead, rather, Rocket's still in the lead in the gold department, but it is fairly even considering the dragon difference. It's pretty much been evened up. I wouldn't say negligible gold, but they're making it work for them.
It's also worth looking at the timings on the compositions and when you expect them to kind of have any kind of potency. Giants are just about reaching the time shortly where they're very strong as a group. You can see Spirit Visage already completed on Knight. Sunstar's not quite at one item, does need a second before he's highly effective. Outside in that side lane as well, only a Triforce, and now the makings, or the very beginning of a Blade of the Ruined King picked up for Smitty J, whereas a lot of the gold on Rocket has gone over to Betsy, who has funneled it into the Ardent Sensor route for that Karma, looking to facilitate the steal back a little bit more than for anybody else. Of course, keep in mind that Ardent Sensor on the AoE shield will also empower Shen and Rek'Sai and give them that extra on-hit damage as well.
That's true, but as far as damage is concerned, they're putting their eggs in the steal back basket. You know, they believe in him just as much as you do, it sounds like. And, you know, I think with Rocket, that's a fair bet.
I should clarify. I believe in him in the promotion tournament and the bottom standings of LCS.
Ah.
I don't believe in Rockat in any other circumstance other than that. I know that sounds harsh on Rockat, but certainly
hey man, they're
out
right
there
now.
For a reason in the promotion tournament. I do still think they are better than their opponents down at that kind of hybrid level between Challenger and LCS that we find ourselves getting closer and closer to.
Yeah, well, the lines get blurred, you know. Knight is going to Ghost on. Steelback will get himself Parang to come in. And Maxlore turns his attention immediately to Raze. Steelback may be safe, but the rest of Giants are moving in here, and they've got the Taric ult on. No one's dying just yet. Inspired, Rocket tried to turn the fight. Will they be able to do it, chasing down the line? Just a few blinking health bars, but no serious damage dealt.
Yeah, no real damage dealt. Nobody died. A lot of summoners used on the side of Rocket when you look at it. Two flashes and ignite the ghost. On the side of Giants, they actually only really used the teleport and a bunch of ultimates at the same time. So Rocket managing to avoid the fight for now. But that was a really nice dodge on the cast from Steelback. Really well-timed little sidestep.
Definitely helps to be able to flash it out as well. Knight looking to come in, pushing. Memento and Betsy trying to push the wave back themselves. And Giants finding they can't do much more here in the mid lane. They will back and spend some of their gold. Still finding themselves a little bit behind Rocket as we approach the 18-minute mark. Next dragon on the board will be Cloud Drake. Speed bonus, much more useful now that they've added a bit more to it. And Memento goes on a bit of a roam to get some vision behind the pit, as well as secure away the red buff.
If they can, they may look to go on Knight right now. Three people down
looks
here,
like
Knight's
it.
A little slippery, still has his flash.
Memento just wanted the Krug.
Yeah.
Knight gives it to him.
Steelback was in lane as well, but couldn't quite close the distance.
Oh, Betsy's shopping.
That pool was available. Betsy, going to be thankful of that patch change, that if you get hit when you're in the shop, closes the shop for you. Not really, but
flashes red. Danger, danger.
Yeah, but it closes the shop now.
That's the important part.
So you're just like, oh.
No, I would rather just flash and be like, close the shop. And you're like, no. No one ever does that, though.
No. I think Steelback, I wouldn't trust in him so much anymore if he refused to stop shopping and just ended up dying.
Sometimes boots are that important. All right, so Dragon's back on live. Giants are around the backside, clearing the vision away, so Rocket do pull the Cloud Drake out of the pit. Should be able to secure it right now. Not a lot of contest available, and Giants know it. They opt instead push towards the mid, see if they can knock it down in time.
So Knight is opting for the Proto Belt variant of Vladimir. Makes him a little less tanky right now. Will likely get the rallies as a follow-up item. Allows him to close the distance very effectively in these fights, get multi-person E's and ultimates through. They do have fairly good engage as it is. They got the Gragas, they got the Sivir, the Taric. Lots of utility in that respect. Of course, can't really overlook Huston's ultimate as well. He had some great ults yesterday to keep his team alive in their first game, I believe it was, against Schalke.
It's hard to, you know, do that with Taric. The delay on the ultimate cast, you have to know exactly when it's coming. And, you know, we're starting to see Taric rise a bit more to prominence, but it's still a very difficult champion kit to pull off.
Now, this is very strange by Betsy, being out in the side lane. The reason for that is he's not really built for side lane pushes. He hasn't got the TP. He hasn't got the Rabadans that Vedius was talking a lot about yesterday when it comes to having that extra presence on the side. Always looks funny when somebody's got Cloud Drake, when you see them running up, it just looks like Betsy right now on Karma has a lot of flatulence. Just that animation, I know it's there to make it seem satisfying that you're running really fast, but it just looks like you really food didn't agree with you.
I suppose that would make you move pretty fast as well.
I guess.
Yeah, so it's appropriate, no matter what. There we go. 21 minutes, Rocket still trying to defend this mid lane. You can see the trap line from Steelback. And the Caitlyn had fallen off a little bit in the meta, still popular with that AD carry. Memento getting his clear on as well. So another Infernal Dragon will be spawning. We have a lot of dragons to fight over this game, that's for certain.
But, 6 minutes.
Exactly. It's almost like clockwork.
I'm glad. I'm glad it is. At this point, for Knight, though, what seems clockwork is he's going to go up against Betsy every single time because he knows he can force Betsy back.
Yeah, at this point, he's gotten, you know, a little bit scary. He's picked up a couple of kills. Betsy's got to get out of here, though. Max Lore goes right. It's like, can he get the juke? Oh, run away! Flash it! Okay, had to burn the summoner, but man, the stealth mission.
Yeah, gets the flash away. Did use Ghost as well. Didn't quite get caught in the right angle of stuns. As Betsy tried to play Secret Agent at that point.
Hustlin was trying to do his geometry homework.
Man, Smitty J is getting closer and closer to the point where he's going to start taking over this game. Nearly at the play to the Rune King, that is the point at which Jax, with two items, can just sit in the side lane against Shen and just wait out Shen's auto attack denial for a long time and then just suddenly turn on and continue to push forward.
Yeah, things are looking good for Giants right now. They have a little bit of time to work with, and even with the trap line, Maxler still able to sidestep a lot of that, just trying to finally finish off this tower. Sanstar not quite in range for the autos, throws the. He's not going to step on it. Throws the spell shield out and then decides he doesn't want to.
You can see the difficulty. Giants don't really have a lot of tower pushing potential outside of Sunstar as well. Knight can kind of step forward for a few autos, but aside from that, the trap line is way too frustrating to deal with. Don't want to get caught on one of those.
And there's so much siege on the side of Rocket as well. We talked about it in the pick and ban phase when they locked in the Kaylin. I mean, this is a lot of siege potential between him and Betsy. And, you know, you can't really dive into it. There's a Shen there, there's a Rek'Sai. You can get bopped and knocked up pretty easily.
Rocket are slowly losing their side lanes, though. Every time, you'll watch it now, Parang will move up to the lane, and as soon as Smitty J comes into the lane, Parang will back away. The same will happen between Betsy and Knight. We've seen it a couple of times already. They're always conceding the side lanes. And what it means is Rocket are going to gradually lose control of the shallow entrances to their jungle. If they can maintain mid-tower for a while longer, that shouldn't actually affect them too much. But if they lose mid-tower, that'll progress into losing deeper aspects of the jungle. The wards will go down from Giants, they'll clear out the pink wards from Rocket, and they have safer passages to move between lanes. Then Giants will hit out the outside turrets, whichever one Jax is not at, and they'll slowly constrict Rocket's vision back towards their base. It's a fairly lengthy process right now, and you can see Steelback is even adjusting where his traps are, so he can't get engaged upon from the side. But still, they just need to clear out this mid lane. Rocket right now, however, have to try and figure out their next move, because they have to do something actively against Giants, or they'll end up just losing their lanes.
Yeah, might be a bit averse to fighting, though, in the open. We saw down in the Dragon Pit a little while ago. They were caught a bit unawares. I think they maybe put a bit too much stock into their trap line, but Giants definitely took it to them right now. And even though the game looks fairly even, it has been Rocket mostly giving the ground, and you can see them kind of getting pushed back, even in the vision. Still some deep wards from Giants, and Rocket have not been able to get past the river line.
Yeah, and here's the swap again. Karma goes to the bottom lane, Shen collects in the top lane, and from there they'll back and do the same swap again. They just always are going to try and keep themselves at this point, push it out as much as they can, and shift things back around, because as long as they don't get TP'd on for Rocket, it's going to be a lengthy game, but Rocket are going to look and hold on until Steelback is actually strong enough. If Steelback gets to the late game on this Caitlyn, very little is actually going to be able to deal with him, but Smitty J is setting the trap for Betsy. This is a little too far pushed up for a Karma.
Here we go, jumps, Counter-Strike, he manages to get it, and that health bar's going way down. Shen's coming in, can't Smitty finish the job? No, he's tethered, flashes away from the taunt! And in goes Sunstar and Maxlore. They want to make the fight happen right now. Betsy's inspired, but can he get away? Memento, Maxlore going in. Memento's not even here, excuse me. Maxlore with the shutdown gold. Parang trying to get away, but the rest of Giants are in hot pursuit. And these flashes just keep on going. Meanwhile, Rocket are pushing down mid lane.
Yeah, this is a big play by Rocket to make sure that they, again, restrict what Giants can do on the map. Parang's still not out, though.
Yeah, Knight just joins up with the rest of his team. Parang will finally fall as Knight jetpacks forward. So Rocket, damage report all said and done. They lose two members, but they gain a tower.
Yeah, they gain a tower. However, they should be able to hold this mid-tower as well. The traps go down. Sunstar doesn't have his flash available, so they can't go aggressive. So Giants will look for the dragon instead. Big wave pushing towards Giants in the top lane. Hustlin manages to avoid that trap, actually. Knight wants to dive, so they can't really defend this tower with only three of them. Now they end up falling. Parang wasn't available to defend it. That is the play that now may turn this game heavily against Rocket.
Giants get what they want there, for sure. A little more infusion of gold, knocking down the outer turret in the mid, and they get themselves another Infernal. And would you look at it, there'll be a third one. Let's take a look at how this all began, though.
This was an adaptation by Giants to make sure that they could kind of bait Rockat forward. Whoever was coming there, they were hoping it was Betsy at that point. They can very easily take them out. This ends up being a very extended chase.
Sick flash from Spitty J.
Nice flash comes out. Sunstar with a flash over the wall to make sure that they can close the gap. And the rest of the fight was kind of easy to pan out from there. As Perrine gave him the runaround. It wasn't quite enough to get him out. And I want to clarify why I say heavily, despite the gold being even. Because I think people will think that's a little unfair on Rocket right now. Is that, again, Giants are being able to play these side lanes so much more effectively and have just reached their item breakpoints. Two items on Civet, two items on Jax. Vlad is at three items now with a Zhonya's Hourglass on top of it. So they are very, very strong with two Infernal Drakes as well. There is a lot of hidden power in the Giants lineup that is only really matched by Rocket's ability to protect, defend, and get the damage output from Caitlyn. Betsy's pretty strong. A lot of that is going towards utility. So if Rocket can get a good fight, this game is still potentially theirs, but Knight's already in.
Yeah, and he took a lot of damage for his trouble, but so did Memento. Maxlor getting chunked out in the back, and Hustlin coming in, looking to get the stun off, has to flash himself back, and in comes Spitty J around the side. They're being popped left, right, and center with Maxlor's barrel. Perrine will take down Spitty J. Rocket still on the retreat, but Steelback gets barrel down, and Knight will fall in the back half of it as Perrine causing mayhem in their back line. Rocket cannot follow this chase, not just yet, but Perrine gets a three-man taunt and Maxlor's going low. Can they finish the damage? Nobody on Rocket wants to go too deep, but Hustlin's falling. It's just Sunstar left. They get the ace, and they're right by Baron.
Massive extended fight for Rocket, and that was the kind of fight they needed. Steelback stayed alive for so long in that and got a lot of escape potential through that the health bars ended up so low. Betsy can easily clean up on this Karma. This game has actually turned right around. It was going to be Steelback's damage that was going to do it, but Karma, at this point, six kills with that Rabadon's. We underestimated the damage. I underestimated the damage that Betsy had at the end of that team fight, and so did Giant. Sunstar did not have any armor pen, wasn't really building towards much crit either, and couldn't output enough damage the longer this goes on. Keep your eyes on Steelback. The Shen ult, possibly too early on Steelback, but he needed to get in the fight there. Steelback wasn't under threat yet until this point. Exhausted, tries to flash out. Again, kites back and gets good damage off. And look at the health bars here. Knight is basically already dead there. Ends up dying during the pool. And from here, it's only Sunstar that is damaged for the Giants in the rest of this fight. And again, Memento kites back very effectively. Sunstar ends up dying because Betsy's going to go aggressive on him with Perrine and the rest of the team here. And it ends up being Rocket able to take that fight. That was the fight that Rocket needed to hold them in this game. And suddenly they've extended their lead greater than it has been in the entire game so far.
Yeah, and Betsy's damage netted him, you know, three kills in that fight. They've started to step it up big time. That next Infernal Drake may just be theirs, but they've already gotten the Baron. And now you can see the mini wave starting to turn all the way around. Since last we checked in at the mini map, the warding coverage has really changed. And Giants are really cowed at this point. There's not much they can get done. Look at how fast these turrets are being shredded through. Rocket found a way back into this game, kiting and making sure they staggered the damage. Giants, in one fell swoop, it's really turned on their heads. Now Inhibitor Tower under fire. Maxlor throws the barrel, but it doesn't go where he wants it. They turn for Steelback, but he is well protected. Giants trying to make this fight happen. Perrine instantly taunting onto Smitty J. Knight takes out Steelback. Maybe they can turn this one around now. Perrine still trying in the back line to disrupt everything, but Memento being chased away. And now Perrine's got to get out of harm's way if he can. Surrounded by Giants members. Looks like he's going to fall here. It is a 2-4. How many can he get it? No! Sunstar staying alive. But they lost an inhib tower for it.
Giants punish a little bit of overcommit from Rocket when it comes to the inhibitor that was going to follow. However, they did just use basically everything they had in that engage. TP was used, flash was used from Smitty J, and that's going to be fairly crucial because the real way back into this game for the Giants would have been Smitty J split pushing. It is fairly tough for them to do that now. Up against the Baron, there are still a couple of members available for Rocket that have that buff to empower the minions, but it's an Infernal Drake in 1 minute's time that could once again turn the tide of this game. It'll be our last Elemental Dragon before the Elder Drake. And again, this was, again, Steelback getting caught out, but being able to kite back a little for this fight. Doesn't have flash from the last fight available, so he's trying to kite back. But Knight, that Hemo Plague, explodes. That is enough to kill him, and Perrine is very, very tough to kill, but he can't actually deal too much damage in response himself. He has enough to kind of pressure onto some stuff for a lot of this fight.
Ooh, that was
so close.
But
it's not quite enough to get that kill and ends up falling
for it. If only Shen still had Vorpal Blades. That would have been a different story.
Maybe at that point. But one thing is evidently clear is that Sansa needs some armor pen coming up fairly soon.
Yeah.
Because he's having a tough time chunking through Parang as it is. But next item should address that situation.
Well, what we're about to address is the next Infernal Drake. Giants, this would be number 3 for them. Rocket are hellbent on stopping it. Parang's got teleport and his ultimate available. Rocket have moved in here. The dragon has been procced. Giants don't want to commit fully to it here. Maxlor will be the one who steps up to the plate. Knight is around the side. He's trying to get a good angle here if he can, but the rest of Rocket are around. We could be in for a good old-fashioned smite fight. Where is it gonna go?
Reset.
Back into the pit. Resetting, they turn their attention towards Memento. Very low in this, but so are Giants.
They used the Tarak ult already, Max.
Oh, they're giving this one up. Rocket, get it! Oh, they needed that.
Rocket get it because the Tarak ultimate too early from Hustlin, a little bit of a misread. It was early enough that should they have fought, it was the right time, but Giants decide to kite back down away from the fight. Don't really want to go aggressive, but Max kind of pieces out from the smite fight at that point, didn't even want to try and take it. So Rocket will continue this aggression on the towers.
Get themselves second tier in the mid, 33 minutes on the clock about, and they push up towards the top looking for more. As you can see, Flying Grabs in the background. Should be pretty happy with this performance, despite the fact that they're promo bound right now. Rocket are showing up big against the favored Giants.
Yeah, and Giants right now, after a loss to Schalke, are now on the back foot against Rocket. It's maybe a little scary for Giants fans right now, considering we are only 2 weeks away from playoffs. But then again, you can also attribute that to Rocket seemingly stepping up this week. They took Fnatic down in one game, now looking to take down one of the other third place contenders in game one of this series.
Yeah, Rocket definitely showing up big right now. The next Baron will be in a couple of minutes. Lead 6,000, or about 5,000 gold still for Rocket. They've got a dragon of every flavor that they can get right about now, and Giants have just been forced to back away from so many objectives. They've got no inner turrets remaining to them. They've got no inhibitor turret on the bottom side, and their vision really doesn't extend past the first leg of their own jungle.
And it all stems from that one fight that Rocket really ended up winning. Rocket did get the early kills and kind of held the game with a slight lead for themselves for a long, long time in this game, but it looked like Giants were about to tip the scales for themselves. The item breakpoints had been matched, and it looked like it was all go for them after getting a couple of kills too, but they just couldn't quite hang on to that fight. And as Betsy was able to turn it around, utilizing the first 3 kills of the game that they got on Karma, turning it back around, and suddenly we find ourselves in a situation where Rocket have cracked part of the base already of Giants.
Yeah.
We're under a minute away from the next Baron. Giants, they look like they want to fight.
On the hunt, Maxlor's going in. Did he just throw the single barrel? Didn't get the ult off in time, or at least didn't get close enough to ult. So that is a key on the hunt burn by Sonstar with a Baron coming up in 40 seconds.
They did, however, get the flash from Steelback.
That is also key.
That is really, when you look at how a lot of these fights have gone, Steelback has been trying to push forward a lot, has been caught without that flash a couple of times. So if that ends up happening again, Steelback, by the way, has the Executioner's Calling. Gonna try and deal with Knight slightly here. Just hit him a couple of times, make sure he can't end up healing up. And it does stop a lot of what Vlad has to offer.
Oh, man.
Of course, have the Ignite as well on Raze.
And the traps just make it so hard for Giants to get in and contest. I mean, that is one cover real difficult to blow through. Rocket controlling the area around this Baron pit utterly right now, but it's no secret that they're going to be going for it. They will start for the rush. Steelback clearing away a little bit. They back off for now as they see many Giants members around. Steelback actually down to half health from Baron. In comes Knight around the side. Protobelt, but he's going to kite away. Instantly, Shen comes in, but Giants are on full aggression. They knock Betsy backwards as he burns his flash to get out of harm's way. Smitty on the front line. Counter-Strike is not going to land. Rocket have disengaged this.
So have Giants, though, but Giants just used a lot of their tools. They used the Hemoplague, they used the Explosive Cast, they used the Tarak Ultimate as well. Memento ults his way over to mid lane just to play Deterrent here, and Giants struggling to get the damage down in these fights.
certainly aren't able to find enough. It looked like for a moment they might have had steal back, but a quick heal and a Shen ult meant that a lot of the damage was denied, even though he took too many hits from the Baron. Down in the bottom lane goes Smitty J. He's gonna be followed by Parang as the wave starts to get pushed back the other direction, but look at this, Raze and Memento back in the Baron pit, clearing out the wards, not gonna start it up just yet. Still too many giants nearby.
Too many, and not really the option to rush it down themselves for Rockat. Yeah.
They are looking back for mid forth. Though. Sonstar takes a ace in the hole, no spell shield on him. He's gonna have to back up for just a second, and again, Rocket keep playing this cat and mouse game.
Yeah, I envision he spell shielded the taunt that came out from Parang. Very rare that that gap would have been closed without it. Maxlor now treading down into dangerous territory.
Oh, they have started it. Maxlor chunked right in the middle of it all. Knight trying to make something happen as the teleport comes in a little bit late. Maxlor incredibly low, and he's going to go down. Raze picks the kill. Smitty, though, gets a three-man counter-strike into the Hemo play, and he's running wild in the back line. Shuts himself down in AD carry, looking for even more. Rocket are collapsing. A triple, looking for another. Parang is going to go down. Guardian Angel just denies for a second, and he taunts away, but Smitty's right behind him. This can only go one way, and it's going to be the quadra kill. Delayed.
Hustlin steals
it
away.
Oh, man.
Oh, I believe Hustlin stole a Penta the other day. This time he's going to steal away
what
a
comeback,
quadra.
Man.
Memento would already pieced himself out of this fight. Oh man. Smitty basically emptied 5 health bars in that fight.
That was the most anticlimactic end.
Gotta get that Taric steal,
yeah.
Man.
Rocket got completely wrecked there, though. This is gonna be hard to come back from, even though they were on such a front foot. Giants now immediately pushing up the top turret, and they should be able to rotate to Baron here.
It always pains me to say these words,
maybe not yet.
The team fighting Jax sometimes finds its potency, and in fights like that where you get the lockdown on multiple people, Rocket were trying to bait here. They go all onto Maxlor, which generally isn't the worst of things, but you can see that, look, Betsy kites back and Knight ends up finding Steelback and Betsy for a lot of this fight. Good stun from Smitty J as a follow-up allows them to hold them in place without a lot of the utility coming out from Karma, and then pretty much is Smitty J just opening up here. Triple kill comes through. That's a third health bar he's emptied. Here's the fourth to put him into Guardian Angel.
He did earn that kill.
Yeah, he earns the kill, but doesn't earn the kill credit, unfortunately. The thing is, Smitty J basically steals it himself here by being close enough to try and hit, takes that actual animation there. He should have taken a step back. That way it would have, avoided the Taric stun, and then he could jump forward. You did
it's
it
all
to
about,
yourself,
it's a team game. It's a team game.
Did it to yourself.
All right, so Giants find themselves still in a gold deficit, and they're still in a tower deficit too, but they did start to close that gap. They also have wrestled a whole lot of map control back. And really importantly, not only is Baron on the rip, but Elder Dragon is live. And that's a big deal for both these teams because they've both secured a significant number of Dragon buffs.
Yeah, it's significant for Giants in the way that it makes their team fighting so much stronger. Empowering 2 Infernals plus giving them that dot, of course, fairly significant. For Rocket, it's more of an all-around buff. They get extra healing, they get the movement, they get the power in team fighting as well. So, certainly,
whoa, Giants are starting this in plain sight. Rocket are going to turn the fight, but Baron's already fallen a little bit low. See if they are calm
Knight
enough to be
inside.
Able to take it. Knight comes around the backside. Memento, they're being knocked once again, but Knight is still able to get the damage out, and he deletes Betsy from the map. Steal back in the back, trying to get the taunt, or trying to get the traps. It's not enough. In goes the Vlad. Knight is cleaning house here, and Parang's going to fall. A triple kill for Knight, and they keep rolling.
Yeah, they want to try and catch Raze here, looking for a potential second wipe on a fight. They didn't get Memento in the first one, but Maxlor has found him in this one. It's going to take a long, long time if they're going to try and kill him. Looks like they want to just focus on the base and not actually allow him to recall from this. Memento can cut the wave, and that's about all he can do. You can see that's what he's sitting there for, delaying that cannon minion. He knows he's not getting out of this situation too easily, so just trying to delay a lot of the push that's coming from Giants, but it doesn't matter. They've got a Jax already that is able to push down. So Giants are only committing Sonstar and Hustlin, although Sonstar is a big part of that push.
Maybe he's just ignoring Raze right now. Forget about it. That inhibitor's dead.
He does not care about it.
And now they're on to Baron. There's not a lot Rocket can really do about this. Memento, he could try to get close enough to the pit for a steal, but it is way too late for it to happen. He just finishes his recall channel. He had no ultimate available anyways. Giants secure everything they wanted.
And this is another fight again where between Steelback and the rest of his team, he can't stay alive for long enough. Dodges out of the cask again, maybe a little fortunate
on the channel too.
Well, they have been using that channel. This time I believe it came down onto Betsy early on. I didn't quite catch the health bar. It may very well have been Steelback and it expired by the time I was double checking. Another fight.
And we've got more. Here we go. Everyone's dazzled for just a second, but now they're getting knocked up. Again, Knight comes around the side. This Vladimir is getting too big to deal with. Memento, Parang falling low, but trying to tank the line. And Smitty, he goes a bit deep here, gets himself a Guardian Angel pop. Or now Knight is still running wild, but Parang's fallen down. Giants really are cleaning this up.
Yeah, Steelback's down again, and now Giants are going to look to close this game out. They've got the Baron buff. They've now got the minion waves as well. Yeah, Memento trying to do the same thing again, trying desperately to hold on to this game, but Giants have managed to turn it back around. It wasn't through their side lane control. It has been through brute forcing the last few fights and finding Steelback before the fight really even begins, not allowing him to stay alive. And Giants are gonna look to shut out the hopes of Rockat. This win will secure 10th place for Rockat, no matter what happens to Origin today.
Giants, it looked a bit scary for them, but they should be able to finish this game off. Memento still being a nuisance, a thorn in the side of Giants, who just can't quite end it yet. Still, two inhibitors. It would be a monster comeback for them if they could pull it off. Memento still bothering them consistently.
He's being a
I'm running
bit
out of
nuisance.
Adjectives for what he is.
Nuisance, obnoxious, like pest, yeah. I'm about out now as well. I think yeah. I used most of the same ones.
I probably should have just been like, yeah, don't use him now. Let's wait if he does it again. But still, I mean, that actually denied the finish from Giants.
It did. It did deny for now. This has been a strange end to the game.
It's been a weird game all around, though.
It's been a very weird
game. Let's be real about it.
For Giants, their strength in fighting has been basically, we're just going to run at you, and as long as we kill Steelback, everything is fine. They're going to now take the Elden Drake, unless some miracle steel comes out from Memento. He is around.
Hustlin was right around the backside, but yeah, Memento, he was looking to see if he could get something off. Not going to be happening. We're 43, almost 44 minutes into this game. The gold really hasn't meant as much. Sonstar going forward for the push. Memento will actually just finish his back channel. And as you said, it really has not been about the side wave since the mid game. Rocket have been trying to hold on, but Giants just keep shoving them in with a team fighting Jax.
Oh, it pains me, Pyra.
I know.
It pains me.
There have been a lot of team fighting Jaxes in Europe this year. A lot of them Smitty J.
Origin have done it. Smitty J's done it. Vitality have done it.
Well, I mean, it comes down to being able to come out of nowhere and land like a 3-4 man stun, right?
Turret just melts 45 minutes into this game.
Giants have had some sick combos, too. I mean, you got to think Knight really doubling up on the Hemo play, and then Smitty being able to take everyone into the CC for just a moment. It's been devastating to Rockat.
It's going
to
be one last ditch attempt for Rockat here. Fight's coming. You can feel it brewing at this point for Rockat.
K-traps aren't stopping them.
They're going to have to try and hold on. They've already got those Howard minions. In goes Maxlaw. Hits a trap.
Waits for it, and they just keep chunking down the turret. Nowhere else to stand right now. The barrel doesn't hit anyone, but it doesn't even matter. Betsy, look at how low they keep chunking him. Raze and Melento are melting like Swiss cheese. Through a hot knife right now. Everyone's going way too low. Knight's going down. This is gonna be it. 45 minutes. Parang comes up just in time to see his hopes and dreams crushed down to dust. Triple kill for the Vladimir. 45 minutes. Giants will take the victory in game number one.
An important win for Giants puts them or keeps them on track for a potential third place spot. For Rockat, unfortunately, that means they can only, at best now, put themselves 1 point closer to Origin, who lead them by 2 points. Rockat can, at maximum, finish 13 points, which is not enough to get up to ninth place.
Yeah, so unfortunately for them, they will be locked in for that final spot in the promotion tournament, finishing out 10th. And, you know, it's obviously a disappointing season so far for Rockat, split as well. But, you know, I mean, they have really improved in the last weeks of this split. And that's a good thing when you're trying to fight for your LCS lives. So they can take some heart from that game.
They can. The competition on day one, that means we now 100% are guaranteed on Thursday to have Rockhat versus Millennium, who I think Rockhat are likely to make it through that game. Could be a close one because Millennium have good fighting. Yeah, exactly. Thursday, you're going
to
find that.
Tune in.
It'll be a fun matchup to watch. However, from there, that's where the competition starts becoming more difficult for Rockhat because they're going to have Origin, whoever wins of Vitality, Schalke, which is currently playing over in the studio on EULCS2. They're going to have Misfits and obviously themselves are the four teams remaining. So, it's an awkward circumstance for them. But Rockhat, it's all in their hands still.
Yep, absolutely. And Giants still all in their hands. But let's take a look back at that game. Let's rewind a little bit because that was 45 minutes of mostly nonstop action. I mean, let's just go all the way back to the first blood and see what happened in there. That was a pretty interesting moment for sure.
Yeah, this first blood when Knight just kind of steps on a trap and then, oops.
It really was a trap.
One thing
but not
about,
that one.
No, not that trap.
This one.
Here was the cue.
Ah!
Got him. One thing about that is... I don't normally share anecdotes about me playing because normally it's not representative, but that's actually a scenario. When you're playing Caitlyn, if you put the traps so that the tower blocks them, don't put them like in view. You can actually hide the model of the trap, and that's exactly what was done there by Steelback. Knight.
There's a reason it's a comfort pick for him.
Knight didn't see the trap go down. He only would have had an audio cue, so didn't quite have the positioning on it. So as he stepped backwards, hit the trap, that's where the headshot came through. Then I'm never going to talk about me playing games ever again.
You learn something useful from it.
So but there it's you go. Fun. Always do that if you're playing Caitlyn.
Yes.
Well, it's not about the sound. It's just about don't walk
well, yeah, don't
past
it. Yeah. That is also very useful.
Caitlyn.
All right, let's take a look at another one here because in the mid game, Rocket, they had this ace and it was right on Baron, and they were able to get so much off of it. And it looked like they were going to take this game.
Yeah, and again, this is another one of these fights. This time, the ultimate from Shen is actually pretty well timed. I think initially I called that it was a little early, perhaps, but the Hemoplague was on Steelback, so it absorbed so much of it. Now in go the rest of the Giants lineup, and Smitty J is trying at this point to team fight. He's not quite strong enough.
That's when team fight Jax doesn't work.
Yeah, it's not as efficient, but Giants and the rest of the team are trying to output more damage, and Sunstar just doesn't have enough. He doesn't have the armor pen to get through Parang. Look at him, he's hardly even scratching him for the entire duration of this fight. Finally starts getting a bit done, but Betsy comes in, boosts the speed to the rest of his team, and suddenly everybody ends up dying.
Yeah. That was pretty much it. And this is a game that just had so many big swings in either direction. It didn't actually change the gold as much, but it resulted in people getting really big, and we were thinking the game was just going to end on a dime. But then we had this 37-minute Baron fight, and Giants just completely cleaned up Rocket. And then Hustlin decides to steal. Well, he didn't decide, but he did steal the quadra kill.
Yeah, he steals it. Smitty J could have kept it.
Hey, man, it fooled me.
Yeah. So this fight was kind of Sunstar caught a lot of the attention of Parang and Memento, and Smitty J just moved up through the fight into the back line, easily dealt with a lot of the damage that was coming out from Rockhat, and from there we can watch Smitty J end up having his own quadra stolen by his own positioning next to Parang. Look at it. Look how much time he's going to have to avoid the stun locking. He knows the animation.
He got greedy.
He could have dodged and got
the
auto.
75 gold, that's a sick assist. That's worth.
Gets the assist. Yeah. So for Giants, you can see out in the back patio area there, getting ready
for
the next
game.
There's
a lot to talk about despite the win. I mean, you've got to be able to lock it up a little bit better for playoffs, especially for a team that's still fighting for that third place spot.
Yeah.
Imagine trying to do this against a team like Fnatic. I don't think it would work out quite so well.
Well, I'm still not sure exactly where to place Fnatic after that.
That is a good question. Yeah.
But
nearly did Giants.
Yeah, I mean, a lot of Giants' fortune now rests completely on themselves. If they get a second win here, that's their job done for the day. Giants are like, okay, well, we'll finish on 27 points. Whatever happens, happens. I said it's on themselves. It's actually on everybody else.
Well, also, you kind of have to bank on the fact that Fnatic are facing off against G2. That's a pretty tough task. But a lot of teams have been able to draw against them. So if they can tie it up, that's still, it's not completely in their own hands, but it's not too far to see a world where Fnatic will take one game at the very least and push themselves up over the edge. But in that tiebreak scenario, if they don't get a single game, Giants move themselves up, and that's really important.
Yeah, it is really important. And obviously, the end of it is going to come to the overall match wins. So Giants currently a one match series win, the 2-0s up against H2K, Giants have 7, H2K have 6. So even if both win today and end up on the same points,
it does work out well for
Giants. It works out well for Giants because they'll have that series win advantage.
It's been an interesting split, man. Giants,
it has.
Third, fourth place. I mean, this is a team that has just done so much work. Still has a lot to go. But, you know, I'm excited to see how they do in the playoffs as well.
I am as well. I'm excited to see how the rest of the day goes.
Oh, yeah, we've got a lot of great games, man. This is just the beginning.
Trying to keep my head in the right place on these tiebreakers.
It does. Everything gets a little complicated. We've got like all the stuff written down. We've got like all people whispering on your ear saying, no, this is what's going to happen. This is going to happen. It is a ridiculous amount of scenarios always, but at least we've shaved a lot of them down as of yesterday.
It's not quite like last split and previous split
where we had
the paper that we fold.
We have 10 tiebreaker possibility.
Cross everything out.
Ridiculous stuff.
Like, we might have 11 games. Not
this time. So we're going to take a quick break, guys. But coming up, we're going to have game 2 between Rocket and Giants. Stick around. We'll be right back.
Do you think we could like bribe the referee to like tell us what they're thinking? Are you bribable?
Depends.
I like the sound of that. No, I'm joking.
It goes back around the side, forcing the flash out of Steelback. Knight is low, and that's a first blood inner flame. And in comes Smitty, and around the backside, he's getting the counter strike on, and Steelback going way too low. Raze gets taken out by Knight, drains the last of his blood.
I'm ulti.
I killed him.
I can bind you, Smitty. I can bind you.
Go Penta, go.
No Penta, just finish this.
Benzi, look at how low they keep chunking him. Raze and Melito are melting like Swiss cheese. 45 minutes, Giants will take the victory in game number 1.